In just a moment, X minus one. But first, there's a certain water commissioner whose interest in the ladies sometimes overshadows his interest in civic affairs. His name is a familiar one, Throckmorton P. Gildersleeve, and he'll pursue his adventures tomorrow night when NBC Radio presents another comic episode of The Great Gildersleeve. So when you hear the familiar voice and hearty laugh of the water commissioner from Summerfield tomorrow, why, stay tuned and enjoy another romantic scramble with the one and only The Great Gildersleeve on this NBC station. And I'll stay tuned for X minus one on NBC.
Countdown for blast off. X minus 5, 4, 3, 2. X minus 1, fire. From the far horizons of the unknown come transcribed tales of new dimensions in time and space. These are stories of the future, adventures in which you'll live in a million could-be years on a thousand maybe worlds. The National Broadcasting Company, in cooperation with Galaxy Science Fiction Magazine, presents
X minus one.
Tonight's story, The Sea Chute, by Isaac Asimov.
We were on our way home to Earth when it happened. Six of us, coming home as passengers aboard the merchant spaceship Starfire, at the start of the Second Interstellar War, the one between Earth and the planet Chloro. And then it happened.
Now hear this. Condition red. Condition red. We are under attack from a Chloran battlecruiser. All hands forward to battle stations. Passengers will remain confined to the after cabin. Condition red. We are being attacked.
The interception by the Chloran cruiser, the murderous running jewel of energy blasts and force field defenses. We huddled in the passenger's after cabin, terrified, not knowing how the battle was going. We could hear the desperate bursts of steam through the steering tubes as the Starfire maneuvered to dodge the enemy attacks. And then...
Now what?
Beginning of the end, you might call it.
Well, what does it mean, Stuart? You were a space pilot.
It means our generators have been drained of energy. We can't fight back.
But, Monsieur...
All right, don't worry. They won't destroy us. They need our ship too badly. They'll simply board us and take over.
But what about the crew?
The crew, Colonel? If they have any sense, they'll surrender. If they choose to fight, they'll... Now, they're coming aboard. Now, be very still.
Oh, Mother in heaven, help
us. Be still. If only those fools on deck will surrender without a struggle.
They are fighting.
Yes, it's the end.
We've got to help them.
All right, don't open that door.
We just can't let them die.
You can't help them.
I'm going.
Stop him.
All right.
Anesthesia.
Shut the door quickly.
Anesthesia, my brother.
That poor fool.
I'll get them. My brother, I swear to God, get them.
Yeah, you better cover his body.
The brutes. The monstrous green-skinned brutes.
They're no more brutes than we are, Colonel. This is a war.
Are you defending them?
I'm merely pointing out the facts.
I ought to strangle you.
Why not save it for the Chloros?
I will. I promise you I will.
They're probably deciding right now what to do with us. We might as well settle down and wait.
We sat there, the five of us, and listened while the Chloran invaders killed off the members of the Starfire's crew. Among us was Colonel Anthony Wyndham, an old Colonel Blimp type with a lame leg. Wyndham had spent his life in the militia back on Earth, but had never seen a battle. There was Demetrius Polyarchitis, who had just watched...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.